our next comic coming to the stage is up from Hattiesburg. Please put your hands together for Devron D. Dennis.
The only black person here dancing with all these white people. I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. I mean, how y'all feeling, man? Y'all okay? Y'all good? Shit. One time for our host, Jay Evan. One time. Oh, man, as y'all can see, I came out to Bruno Mars. Man, I love this guy. Bruno is one of my favorite performers out right now. Bruno has his song entitled Grenade. Listen. I love the song, I just hate the concept, okay? Let's talk about why. First and foremost, like, I have a question. Like, baby, what the fuck did you do to make a nigga wanna throw a bomb at you? Let's talk about that shit. Like, what? What, like, is this one thing to wanna kill a bitch, but it's a whole other thing to wanna demolish her to make sure she's not here at all anymore. That's just something that I have on my mind. Yo, speaking of good music, man, I don't know if y'all know this, but earlier this year, Beyonce dropped her new album entitled Lemonade. Dope album, love the album. But the album scared me a little bit. About five songs in, she's talking about how Jay-Z ain't shit, he cheated on her. And that scared me because I thought they were gonna get a divorce, but they can't do that because there are only three relationships that I really believe in order for me to believe in commitment. There's Jay-Z and Beyonce, Barack and Michelle, and Stevie Wonder and his dreads. Like, those are the three things that need to happen in order for me to believe in commitment. Those three things cannot separate, I'm sorry, I just can't allow that to happen. But speaking of the album, man, my favorite song on the album is a song entitled Formation. You know, my daddy Alabama, my mom Louisiana, that right there. My favorite part in the song is when she go, when he fuck me good, I take his ass to Red Lobster. When he fuck me good, I take his ass to Red Lobster. Then I thought about it. I ain't never been to Red Lobster. Now I'm in the gym just trying to get my stamina up. Like, you know what? You deserve Red Lobster, bro. You deserve it. That's like on my vision board. 2K16, Red Lobster. That's what I want. By the end of the year, damn it. Nah, cause like right now, I understand that sex with me is on the radio like McDonald's. Like, it won't blow you away, but it'll leave you satisfied. Let me explain what I mean. Now, not too long ago, did she kick me up? She was like, yo, D, can I come through? I said, yeah, girl, you can come through. But hey, if you're coming through, I need you to stop by the store and get us some condoms. She was like, all right, cool. Y'all, she got there. This motherfucker pulled a box of extra large magnums. I just. Nah, baby, you're not finna have that much fun. Listen, I can do a magnum, but you've been a little bit greedy right now. Like, I can see us right now. Come on, D, go deeper. Deeper, baby, deeper. Now I gotta give him my customer service speech. Listen, ma'am, I'm sorry if I've come to inconvenience you at this moment in time, but there's not much more that we can do about the current situation that we have at hand. Now, what I can do is offer you a similar product. It's not as big as the one that you originally wanted, but it does do the exact same thing. Are you interested? All right, cool. Thank you for shopping with your boy, D. Like, people, I understand who and why I am in life. With that being said, I don't like the pressure that society has put on me because I'm a man. Because I was born with a penis, there are things I'm expected to do. Like, if I walk out of here right now and I see a man fighting a woman, I supposed to go fight him. She and me. Look, I'm going to my car. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Fuck that. Hold up. I'm not saying I condone men hitting women. It's just that I don't condone a man hitting me either. So I'm going to get to the safety of my vehicle. Fuck the bullshit. No. No, not going to allow that to happen. Man, yo, I want to be honest with y'all for a second, man. I'm a little bit terrified right now, okay? The reason being is because Barack Obama has been the only president I've known my entire adult life. Like, I didn't go through the Bush era. I was a kid when that happened. So it had nothing to do with me. But it's scaring me because, like, Barack, he kind of doing like what my daddy did. Like, he came in for a second, now he's gonna leave and just never come back. The shit is crazy. And it's really fucking with me because, like, I was there when Barack got inaugurated, right? Like, I was there. With me being a black man, my parents thought it would be important for me to go see the first black president. What they didn't tell me when they sent me up there was how goddamn cold it was gonna be when I got up there, motherfucker. And I'm from Mississippi originally. It don't get that fucking cold. Like, it's cold maybe 5 days out the entire winter. Not up there. The wind is very disrespectful in D.C. Very. It was so fucking cold, I was out there crying. I was just... I was just crying. My teacher, she was trying to console me. She was like, listen, I know you don't understand it right now, but this is our first black president. This is gonna mean something to you when you get older. You get older than life. And I remember looking this lady in her face and saying, listen, fuck you and fuck him. I won't go home. This is bullshit. I don't even know this nigga like that. Fuck that. Fuck him. I don't know him like that. And Mr. President, if you oversee this, I apologize in advance. I didn't know anything, but I was not woke at all. I'm sorry, Mr. President. Nah, man, but the shit is crazy because now I gotta pick somebody new. Like, okay, I'm black. You don't vote Republican, so Trump is out of the picture. That's not right. So I gotta pick between Bernie and Hillary, right? And think of Bernie, like, I like Bernie. Bernie cool, but Bernie is also 126 years old. Like, that kind of scares me a little bit. Another thing about Bernie is, man, I don't like all this free shit he keep talking about. Like, every time you ask Bernie a question, you're like, I'm gonna make it free. Bernie, what about this? I'm gonna make it free. See, I don't trust this shit, because have you ever been to the mall and somebody trying to give you a free cell phone? Like, you can get this for free, you can get that for free, then you end up with like a $200 phone bill. Like, I don't like that shit. That's what I think Bernie on right now. I don't like it. And then Hillary, she cool, but Hillary kind of like that girlfriend you stole from another nigga. Like, you like her, you just can't trust this motherfucker. Like, every time she leave the room, you trying to figure out, like, what the fuck is she? I know this bitch is up to something. I know it. I know this shit. But nah, man, as I get older, I'm getting more aware of the shit that's happening in the world. Like, recently, Mississippi, we just passed this law that said April was gonna be Confederate Heritage Month, right? And, like, I just wanna know, like, didn't we fucking lose that war? Like, what are we celebrating, man? What is there to celebrate? I just need to know. And this is another thing I really wanna know, because, like, when y'all sitting down celebrating, because I'm black, you know I'm not celebrating. When y'all sitting down celebrating, I wanna know, like, y'all just sit around and go, you know what, back in the day, the fuck niggas up. Fast forward 2016. We still can fuck niggas up. Like, I just want to know what's happening here. Another law that we just passed. This is the dumbest law in the world. This is the law that says that you can legally discriminate against somebody based on your religion. I call it bullshit. Like, I know what the law really about. Let's be honest for a second. That law is really about people who are not comfortable with seeing two men kissing, okay? That's what it is. Because nobody gives a fuck when two women are kissing. Matter of fact, I remember the first time I seen two women kissing. I just sat there and I looked and I was just, well, damn, okay, shit. Oh, man. I love getting on stage, man. But every time I'm on stage, I have to talk about my son, man. My son just turned 4. He's my little guy. And my son, he at that point now where he wants to know shit. Like, he came up to me the other day. He was like, yo, dad, what's this? It's a microwave, son. What do they do? He heats up hot pockets and pizza rolls and dad's supply for you, baby. Oh. Dad, what's this? It's a dishwasher, son. What do they do? Like, come on, my nigga, don't be stupid. Like, it's fucking self-explanatory. Why is the fucking dishes? Like, don't. Come on, think here, think. And he can see that I'm frustrated. So he leave, and he come back like stupid as time. He go, dad! Dad! What's this? What's this? I look, and I go, there's an extra large Magnum, son. What they do? I don't know. I wish I could tell you. I really do. They cause low self-esteem for daddy. I do know that shit. Nah, man, I get on this stage and I talk a lot of shit about my son because I love him. Now, his mama, that's another story. Like, I know a lot of comics get on stage and say they wish their baby mamas would die. I'm not gonna say that because I don't want full custody of my son. So what I will say... just so she can understand that there's more to life than child support. She had me in the court the other day, the judge looking at me using words I don't use on an everyday basis. He looked at me and go, Mr. Dennis? I said, yes, Your Honor. I'm sorry to inform you, but we're gonna have to start garnishing your paycheck. I'm sorry, Your Honor, garnish? Give me 1 second. Yo, Siri, define garnish. We can't, no, we're not gonna be able to do that. Yo, bro, that's my time. My name is D, you can be whatever you wanna be. I thank y'all and I thank God.